Give us the teaching of Marcus Garvey.
Tap.
As always, grace first.
Grace first.
So tonight, before I start, I'm going to ask the elders for permission to continue.
Permission granted.
Someone asked me this evening why I was selected to speak this evening. It made me sort of consider what I was going to say this evening. And I know that Kwanzaa, this year's Kwanzaa is about love, make it happen, correct?
Yes, sir.
And today is NIA, which means purpose. And me as a Garveyite, it is my purpose to educate the people. It is for the babies that we see up here earlier. We want to make sure that we have clarity in information. So the information I wanted to share with you real briefly is the poem that we read earlier with this flag in mind is a poem. The actual pledge, I'd like to read to you now, if you don't mind. You can stand if you will. The flag is here.
Ashe.
I commit my body, mind, and spirit to the defense, protection, and security of the red, black, and green. I dedicate my life to the redemption of Mother Africa and scattered black children. I accept myself and my descendants the teachings of universal African nationalism and promise that my children be instilled with the purpose and knowledge of themselves as African people in order that our struggle will neither falter nor fail. So all black people are free through one God, one name, one destiny. Ashe.
Ashe.
Thank you very much for that. So, just to let you know, I do come here as the president of Local Division 433. Quick announcement, March 1st, the 11th, Marcus Garvey will be visiting Buffalo again for our four-year anniversary. Please look for that event page on Facebook. I would like to see all of you there to continue this legacy and to be part of history. When I speak, the words that you hear me speak are not my own. I speak from 100 years of ancestry, 100 years of Garveyites, millions of Garveyites who've gone through the legacy of nation building. Ashe?
Ashe.
So when we speak about NIA, we speak about purpose. There is no greater purpose for the African than the unification of the African people. Yes?
Yes.
Ashe.
So when I speak here, I represent the Buffalo Division 79, who have over 1,000 members who will come out to see the Honorable Marcus Messiah Garvey speak here in Buffalo. 1,000 Garveyites here in Buffalo, black Buffalonians who took home the message and built. We had two of the first black doctors here in Buffalo, one of whom had a clinic dedicated to women and babies. Yes? Is that purpose? Is that love?
Yes. Ashe.
We're here. Come on, get the energy up. Is that NIA? Is that purpose?
Yes, I say.
We're talking about over 1,000 Garveyites who have 30 plus businesses with the intent on building a nation. Is that purpose? Is that love? Yes. That is the purpose that we want to make sure that we come with today and the drive that we want to make sure we instill in folks today so that they can see that there is no end to that mission. When we speak about the Honorable Marcus Messiah Garvey and what he was trying to do, he was trying to organize the nation. It's not just an organization, it's not just a club. This is a government structure to make sure our people benefit in the future. Yes? Well, don't get quiet on your mouth. This is the fun celebration. This is needed. This is our purpose. Yes? So do we agree that Marcus Messiah Garvey was right when he said that unification is a must and it is the only solution for our people?
Yes.
Do we agree that one God, one aim, one destiny is the way?
Yes.
Yes, well, let me hear you say,
one God,
one aim,
one destiny.
One God,
one aim,
one destiny. Come on, people, you gotta talk.
One destiny.
One God.
One name.
One destiny.
One destiny.
Race first.
NIA.
That's the word.